It's probably like 20 minutes of showtime. I feel ready as shit.
BK the Ruler is a vessel without fear. I honestly believe that everything that I'm doing is gonna stick. I would describe my sound as unseen, unheard of. I can't go back to anything ever. Like, I can't make what I was making a month ago, a week ago, or even yesterday.
It's probably gonna be a crazy ass growth. It's gonna be a crazy ass dot.
It's level five. It's level five. Do you think that, I don't know what to tell you, went crazy at Boiler Room?
It was a good start, but it didn't go crazy.
But I think this is a different crowd, yeah. This is more hype crowd.
I think Roll Around Miami's definitely giving lit. People bought tickets from all over. They're definitely trying to go up. I've been dreaming of Roll Around Miami since I was so young. Like, it almost feels surreal. I can't even show emotion right now. I'm not gonna believe it until I'm there. Everyone's gonna be here, and I'm gonna give them a show, I swear. First song, Double Up, unreleased. Second song, question mark song. Not unreleased, but like SoundCloud exclusive drop. Third song, Through to You with Ski. Fourth song, Left and Right. Fifth song, Santani. Sixth song, Are We Done? Seventh song, Official. Eighth song, Okay, Okay. And ninth song, Invaders. 10th song, Tweaking Together. Lit.
All right. I'm fucking. Yeah. 20 minute set. We always do this before her sets. It's always
we
like,
always choose it right from our set. I don't know.
It's just like a feeling we get. We never plan it.
Yeah, we never plan it. I feel like when we plan it, that's when shit fuck up.
Yeah, and we never rehearse either.
We don't rehearse. We don't rehearse.
Yeah. Ever since the first show we've done together.
Yeah. I came with my name, all my older songs, I was always saying, the rule of something, something. So I was just like, nah, how about BK the Ruler? And it was like, nah, fuck that shit ass. I was like, nah, bro, I wanna go up BK the Ruler. And that shit ended up being stamped, like fire. I definitely would say that some of my music is alternative. I would say like, maybe it, all my music has a little bit of an alternative swag in it. I listen to damn near everything. The sounds that I be finding is like the next sounds. Like I be finding underground artists, like underground producers. I be listening to all types of stuff. And I listen to a lot of old stuff too, like to get inspiration for my new stuff. I'm putting bangers on this. I'm putting bangers on this. Unreleased on this, high energy on it. But I feel like I'm gonna be on stage cooling, but I do want to give the crowd just like, you know what I'm saying? I don't think I should be jumping too much. When people ask me if I'm hip hop, no. I'm rapping and stuff, but it's not hip hop. You know like heart palpitations? I would say that reminds me of my flow. Like, it's like, then it stops, then does something else. Or it's like, doo, 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 doo. It's not like one, two, three, four, one, two, three, four. It's no time. I feel like it's gonna be a whole new thing. It's gonna be a whole new thing. I can't even lie. It's gonna be way more genres, new flows, new everything. It's gonna be whole new waves. I don't know. I just don't think it's gonna exist. I think it's gonna be so different that the name isn't fitting anymore. I actually started music when I was 14. I was going to like underground like hip hop rap shows, but I was like, I think 15, 16. So it was like on the weekends, like after school. And I was just a young nigga just performing every weekend, performing. And then I just started getting really big from performing like in Atlanta. That's really how I stamped my name was the shows. Yeah. Even just having experiences and growing up in Atlanta definitely made my music like way more unorthodox. I always think about how my music would be if I grew up anywhere else. I just couldn't envision it. We are introducing our new, you know, little show, and we are calling it
Siamese Gins.
So we are the Siamese Gins. Well, I will be making a mocktail.
I'll be making a cocktail.
She'll be making a cocktail.
We're making a blueberry honey bun cocktail mocktail.
Basically what we're gonna do is we just about to smash the blueberries.
Typically you would, you know, like muddle them,
but we don't got that.
But
we're gonna do it this way. Our hands are clean. We gonna grab the muff. We just gonna, that's it. Motherfucking mint leaves.
Yo. A dash of salt.
It's a little sprinkle, bro. She's a little bit better at this than me, but hey.
That's how I make my money, y'all. So. Oh yeah, she's a bartender. I am a. I'm a rapper. So. She has tequila, and I have ginger beer.
Don't put it all the way to the front.
And now.
We try.
We have. The infamous. Blueberry honey bun. Oh no, it's lit.
It's like tequila, but
hey bro, we gotta go. I don't know. Shit. But we really rushing. I don't even know why I'm acting so calm. Look at this traffic. Yo. Bro, cause this nigga's talking to the nigga in the whip. Yo. God, what are you trying to tell me right now? It's 6:40?
No,
bro, don't do that.
No. 13.
Come on, come on, come on. Where the fuck we going? I'm on it. 5 minutes. Yeah. Straight there. All right. Thank you so much. All right. Thank you. Hi. How are you doing? Scanners.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
Come on. Do that. Come on. Bro. Like right before I go on, I'm so nervous. It's kind of like my life is like, I don't really remember anything from when I'm on there. I just kind of lose myself. It's like I blank out and I just go nuts.
But these nets I pay. Okay. I got shit to say. Back on market play. Turn these little hoes gay. Yeah, what can I say? I just spoke my mind. That boy called me crazy.
And I just give. The fans, all my energy. If you don't have a connection with your fans, you're gonna fall. It feels really good, but sometimes it can feel overwhelming. When I go in the studio, I gotta make sure I'm giving it my all with my emotions. Like, I can't just go in the studio and fuck off because of how much my music impacts people, you know? Now, like, for music, we're going insane and we're starting to just do whatever the hell we want and being recognized for it, for our talents, especially young Black women. Like, women, as the years go on, we just evolve, meaning, like, I'm gonna relay the message way better, frequencies way higher, music will evolve, and the evolving will never stop as long as I stay true to this shit.
Good shit.
Thank you.
See, that was easy. It wasn't stressful at all getting here.
We going back to the whip?
Right on time.
Let's go. Fucking made it. It's probably gonna be a crazy ass, bro. It's gonna be a crazy ass doc. That's why that happened. That's why we almost got in late. So
okay. It's the craziest footage.
That's what God was trying to tell me, bro. I hope you got that in the car. And I was like, God, what are you trying to tell me? Bro, this is what he was trying to tell me.
I feel like all these niggas who doubted me, I'm praying for y'all. I'm praying for y'all because it's gonna be bad for y'all.
I was 2 minutes late to my set, bro, because of traffic. As soon as I got on the stage, motherfuckers was waiting for me. I got on the stage. I rocked the stage. That's it. That's it. As soon as I got off the stage, back at the car, like, this shit was meant, bro. This shit was meant. If it wasn't meant for me to do this, I wouldn't have made that set. Hey, Rolling Loud, don't be letting niggas be late. But they let me be late. I am BKTheRula. I look crazy as shit. This is my motherfucking 6 hours.